Alright, I am back. And we're gonna start our day. And I believe this is the day when that one person is coming here that we need the 4 Asian officers for. So wait, before I do that, let's look at the catalog. Coming soon. So, okay. So we have more new... We're just gonna buy them all. Okay. So now we will go ahead and play this. This one isn't bad. Yeah, keep up the good work. Awesome. Ooh. 50% with the staff, and we're looking pretty good. We are 1/10 of the way to our goal, so that isn't terrible. After what, 2 weeks? We're at 20 days. Alright. My student reported, wow, this is a loud album. Okay, wait. I'm sorry. I really need something a bit quieter. There. It's just easier. A student reported seeing a truck drive into the yard at the hostel. A fat man climbed out and began to slice up a bench with a chainsaw. Some other students tried to intervene, but the man threatened them with the chainsaw, saying, "I asked you nicely to keep quiet at night. Now you can park your yellow asses someplace else." Alright, that's not a good thing. Don't go and brandish chainsaws at people. It's not a smart decision. I mean, I guess it is if you want to do, like, suicide by cop. I think guns are probably a better option for that, though. Uh-oh. Alright, so we will send a couple of officers there. And a call has come in from the Secretary of the Law Office of Johnson, Jergen, and Katz. She responded that a woman wearing an expensive fur coat and high heels entered the offices of the senior partners of the firm and asked the secretary not to disturb them. Shortly thereafter, shots rang out from the office. Wonderful. We're just gonna send the 2 for now. Hope for the best. Alright, everyone got out okay. So let's go back here and then shut him. Wait, who was it that we brought on? I was pretty sure that we brought someone on. Oh, this is the B shift. There we go. So it was this person. So we'll move him back to the A shift. The office door is closed, but inside the sounds of men screaming, gunshots, and breaking glass can be heard. Let's not announce our presence. A bald man in a suit is laying in a pool of blood. A woman in a fur coat is standing on the table taking aim at two other men who are hiding behind an overturned bookcase. Let's choose a table leg. Aw, oh, man. So apparently that was not a good decision. Some punks ransacked the house of a family member. It seems like they were looking for something. Something other than money. Maybe a notebook with a list of important contacts. Let's lock up these scumbags before they can do any real damage. I agree. And I should be able to hire someone new now that someone died, but okay. Poor guy. He had three stripes, too. Alright, dear Mr. Boyd, the TV show I produce, Justice for All, suffered a terrible drop in ratings last month. Our polls suggest that our viewers stopped finding the shows believable. We are currently shooting the next season, and for one episode, we need a real cop who will portray a cop pervert who is kidnapping young girls and raping them in his car. We don't have any huge budget, but I think we can afford a couple thousand for you and for the cop who will play the part in the show. And plus, everyone in the city will see him in the show.
Yeah, but you're having him portrayed as a rapist. A kid rapist on top of that.
At the same time, a couple thousand sounds pretty good. Oh, I know. We'll throw him in. I have to keep him employed regardless. So if he quits, and it's probably unlikely that he'll quit. So I think we'll be good. A call just came in from a bank branch in the center of the city. A man entered wired with explosives. He threatened to blow himself up along with everyone nearby unless he was allowed to speak with the press and TV within the hour. The man claims that the bank took away his house after failure to repay a loan which he says he never took out. Alright, so we're going to send two of our best cops, him, and the SWAT team. Alright, we have two cops coming back. One of our poor cops is dead. Fuck you, Boyd. Take your fucking orders and shove them up your better half. I quit. Well, he quit. He wasn't that... I had a feeling that would probably happen. That's why I didn't send a good cop. Yay, 3,000. And now I can hire someone new. And I'll take that for the B shift, and then I still need one for the A shift. And bomb report, and everyone was a clean break. I'm so happy with that. So it looks like we're doing pretty well. I'd like to give her more stripes. She's had 15 successful assignments and 0 failed assignments. She is awesome. I like her. I want to give her another stripe. Our family has several city officials on payroll. One of them is ushering some valuable items through the public transport system. The goods were slated to ship out tomorrow, but it looks like there's some punks who want to dump the cargo overboard before it even clears the dock. What our man in the port says that they bribed some guards. Too bad they weren't smart enough to bribe the police. Send those two. And I think we're getting pretty close to the end of our night. No, not quite. Getting there, but not quite to the end of our shift. I'm kind of glad that he quit. I hope that doesn't, seems to have alcohol problems. Damn right. I'm pretty sure we hired him because of that one person who was donating enough to pay for three cop salaries. But he, his nephew had to be one of them, and his nephew was fucking alcoholic. The store manager reports that a long-haired old man with a large knife broke in. He's ripping out the lining of our sofas, shouting, "Where's my money?" But put this cook in a straitjacket. He's obviously sick. Anyway, come quick. He's hiding in the back. We'll send three. And I still have four left, plus the SWAT team and the paddy wagon. So I think we're doing pretty good. Pretty well. And, oh, investigations. How's our investigation coming along? Oh, that's right. Okay. And yours? How is your investigation coming along? Not quite well enough. Ah, there we go. All right. So, one, two, three, four, five. So this should be good enough. I just can't remember what order these go in. Yeah, that wasn't it. I figured it wasn't it. So let's say this. Nope. That's not the one I wanted. No. Okay, I will be right back. I'm just going to fiddle this around, see if I can figure this out myself. There we go. We got it. And it took four fucking detectives. Alright, let's go ahead and send two cops. And then for the investigation, we'll go ahead and assign a couple of extra detectives to that. Okay, that was the destruction of property. Yes, we found money. What do you mean, sell money? Alright, fine. Yeah, I guess ask the mafia to sell. I don't understand why you wouldn't, like, just trade it with the mafia, maybe. Well, I guess the mafia wouldn't do a straight trade, but still. And, come on, that investigation should wrap up pretty soon. Oh, it was the wrong place. Damn. All right, yeah, let's end the day. All right, we're still doing pretty well. All right, yeah, we're going to declare him dead. I don't like being short-staffed. I would rather have the staff. Truckers unhappy with suburban roads. Fire at the puppet theater. Two actors dead. Okay, that's an interesting, I like that headline. Freiburg gymnast wins regional competition. My neighbor died and his wife asked me to help him with the funeral arrangements. Can I take the day? Yeah. I'm too tired. I can hardly walk straight. Can I go home? You look tired, so yes. Alright, down one detective and one cop. And our best cop, too, which that kind of sucks, but okay. Alright, so, oh,
So apparently I can't use that middle one. Hopefully this one isn't too loud. That one's up. Oh, I like this. I like this a lot. But I can't because she's off. Oh, I love this. A girl shouted over the phone that her grandmother has been killed at her home. Send two. Oh, the mafia. Wow! So we'll share 50%. You always have to share 50% with the staff because I need them to go and help the mafia without any questions. So they'll get kickbacks every now and then. A few drunks were playing darts and one of them got one in the shoulder. A fight broke out, which was quickly joined by other patrons of the bar. Then three plus the paddy wagon. I love this. The road to the house is strewn with corpses of drowned dogs. What the fuck? The lights inside the house are on, but the door is locked. Find another way in. A bleeding elderly woman is lying on the floor in the living room. Check the backyard, check whether the woman is still alive. I don't see how that did anything, but okay. And for the fight, fender cut, police unharmed. Guessing no civilians were harmed, so that's good. So that's the crime trap, investigation trap, and then threaten. Okay. I'm just now realizing we still have three other options that haven't opened up, so this game will get more complex. I'm happy to see that. And the family bank just called in a report of a strange man in a leather jacket with fake documents trying to empty one of our accounts. Obviously, it's one of Vargas' agents, but it's such a stupid move. We don't want to get our hands dirty with this. Just lock him away in a filthy cell. And that's a pretty straightforward one. I'm just gonna send my worst cop just in case. Let's see, a cashier just called in, her voice is in a whisper. Two suspicious black men have entered the store. They spent a few minutes browsing the rack with the expensive whiskey, and now they're whispering to each other and looking back at me. It looks like they're planning on robbing the store. I don't know about that. I'm going to send a really good cop because I think this could be handled diplomatically. Well, it has four here, though. So, Alright, I'll send two, but that's all I'm sending. And two, if it is indeed, like, a robbery about to take place, then two should still be able to handle it. Especially since it hasn't gotten to, like, a major point yet. How's our investigation coming? Alright. The men were unarmed and just doing a little shopping. That's what I figured. They were picking out an expensive bottle of whiskey as a gift for their grandfather on his anniversary. See? See what happens when you, I mean, I guess if you are regularly robbed, I kind of understand that vigilant nature, but I don't know, I felt like that was pretty clearly not, someone wasn't going to actually rob anything. A passerby witnessed three people trying to break into an ATM. A pickup truck was parked nearby, its engine still on, with another man behind the wheel. Looks like they're trying to grab the ATM and carry it away in the truck. Okay. Send two there. We probably won't catch them. Like, once you show up, they'll probably take off. Especially if the car's still running. Like, it's... wouldn't be hard. Oh! Okay, I guess it's more serious than we thought. I'll send two more. But I'd like to keep two teams of partners available. Some punks are throwing Molotov cocktails into the office building where we make book. Eyewitnesses say the idiots keep throwing bottle after bottle even though building is already falling apart. They're probably still somewhere nearby. I'm not going to say my best cops for that. I want to say my best cops for the seriously violent crimes. Destruction of property, while bad, and I agree with sending a message to Vargas people, like, it's not quite the same thing. Oh, yay, we have two more frames. Okay, so I'm going to try to see if, like, this is correct and try to just utilize these five frames for a little bit. So we have that one, that one, that one, that one, and that one. Huh. So he's filling it up there, and then he's moving there, and then he's selling it. So I think we have money plus booze, then is... he's either breaking in or leaving. I'm not sure which one that is. Oh, wait, no, we have an extra one. All right. So let's just remove all those. I didn't count correctly, apparently. There's only four slides, and we have five. So we'll go here, 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 and here. And that wasn't correct, so we will go clear that one out and that one out. And then put it there and there. Okay, so that's not working. All right, I will be back. I'm gonna mess around with this a little bit.